I'm now going to talk about the idea of independent events, which we've actually already encountered, in that when you flip a coin or roll dice, the outcome of a coin flip or a die roll isn't going to tell you anything about the outcome of a new coin toss or a die roll unless you have some very peculiar coins or dice. Okay, and we're going to formalize this by saying that two events, A and B, are independent, which we'll denote by this thing that looks like an upside down T. A is independent of B if the probability of A and B occurring is the same as the probability of A times the probability of B. So if you remember, if for example, if we have two coins that we're tossing and we say, what is the probability that both coins are heads? We can actually just split up into the probability of heads multiplied by probability of heads. We don't have to somehow consider what if the coins somehow have some kind of interaction. Okay? And a different way to view this definition for what it means for two events to be independent is that if probability of A is greater than zero, then it means that using the product rule for events, we can take this left-hand side and write it as probability of B given A times probability of A equals, and then the right hand side. Okay, so the product rule is always true for any two events. Here we need to assume that the probability of A is greater than zero. Okay, so I write this out. Okay, if probability of A is greater than zero, I can say this using the product rule, and long and behold, these cancel out, and note what we are left with. What we're left with says the probability of B given A is the same as the probability of B, meaning that once we observe that A occurred, what we know about B is still the same. The probability of B given A is just still going to be the probability of B as if we didn't even observe A. Okay? And of course, the same is true if the probability of B is greater than zero. We have a similar thing where we can conclude that probability of A given B is the same as the probability of A. Here, again, the idea is that knowing B doesn't tell us anything new about event A.